Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome to Kern's Guitars. As you can tell, the energy level is down drastically from my last video. Reason being is I was on a mountaintop because of the carving, but ever since then I've been tumbling down the mountain. To be quite honest with you, I don't know if I'm going to be able to finish. I don't know if this is going to be my farewell to the great guitar build-off. We'll see. So problems I've been having is my neck pocket is kind of wonky. Tried to repair it in the first or second video. It's come back to bite me again, so I've had to do some finagling with that to try to get that to work. I mean, aside from shoving in some shims to make it look good, I want this guitar to last and to play good and be structurally sound, so if I'm going to fix it, I'm going to fix it right. It doesn't matter how long it takes. Fretboard looks beautiful. The only problem was after I radiused it, sanded it down, looked it over real good. Right here, we're about the, what is this, 12, we're about the 15th to 17th fret. There was a little chip, a little check. So I looked at it and I was like, I'll probably sand that off. So I went to sand it off and all it did is a spread. What that little chip was when I was gluing it all together, this part wasn't securely tightened. So, you know, what it did is pieces actually separated on me. So I had a line from here to roughly here, just seam just opened right up on me. And I'm gonna zoom in here in a minute. As you can tell, right through here, this is after I've sanded it. It's very wonky. You could say, just sand it some more. I could, but it's getting kind of thin. I don't want the fretboard to be paper thin, and I don't want these chips and stuff to show. So I gotta figure out a way to solve that. Hopefully I figured out the neck pocket. It's just been one thing after another. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to work on this neck and I'm going to hopefully get the fretboard situated. If I can't get it situated, I'm going to have to go to plan B, which is just a single piece. Definitely not as much of a looker, but hey, you got to do what you got to do to finish up the contest, right? So this is always on the back burner. It's not a bad piece, but we'll see what happens. Another option I have is to cut this back and throw on some binding. I could use this piece too. Instead of using it for a fretboard, I can use it to bind. Well, not that side, obviously. And that way it'll be the same, at least the same wood. It would cover up this end, so I wouldn't have to tear it down so much. But right now I'm going to try sanding it a little bit. If it gets any worse, then I'm going to have to take this fretboard off because I don't have a rabbit cutter small enough. So I'll have to remove the fretboard, cut it down on the bandsaw, cut some pieces of that to use as binding for this. And hopefully that'll solve the situation for that. And then I can tackle the body. Alright, let's see what I can destroy now.
Just getting a rough shape now at the first fret and the 12th fret. Start my angle and then I can continue it all the way to the heel. This was done before I noticed the problem with the fretboard. If I would have noticed that ahead of time, I wouldn't have done this. I would have dealt with the fretboard first. I'm here and putting a radius on the original fretboard. Went for a compound radius. Went from 7 up at the nut. So I do a lot of chord work, to about 12 or 14 at the pickup end. Started out building guitars after I saw Ben Crow's video, Clarity, and he was putting on his radius with a plane. It was compound radius, and ever since then, that's the way I've done it. It's just a whole lot easier and takes a lot less time. Damn, that's a pretty fretboard, isn't it? Clean out all the fret slots. I had to use the brush because I tried to blow it out, but I forgot I was still wearing my face mask. It's kind of hard to blow through a face mask. And there's the chips. This is our first attempt. I'm gonna try to sand them out.
Okay, I'm not sure if you can see it, but it starts right about here. And it goes all the way down to about here. This is that ridge. It's all in this deep. I mean, even if I do a binding, it's gonna have to be a deep binding. So I'm hoping the sanding will cover it. And as far as thicknesses, we're getting really thin. We're at about 4.5 mil. Which is as low as I like to make it. This side isn't too bad, this side's a little thicker. But I'd really like to keep this if I could. So, let's see what happens. Pencil on it so we don't mess up the radius too much. You can tell here I pretty much sanded my whole fret slot out on these. That's a lot of sanding. Not putting any pressure. Let the tool do the work.
jury's still out on this one. It doesn't seem to be going back any further. So I'm hoping if I can blend this down, it'll take care of it, maybe? This is where I realized it's not working the way I played it. This ridge is just not going away to save my life. As you can tell, I'm just flicking up pieces onto the edge. It's gonna start to go downhill really fast here in a minute. And this is where I decide that this one is toast. That sucks. Oh well. One last ditch attempt to save it. Gonna get all this Coca-Cola dust and try to fill it and see what it looks like. Yeah, I'm in panic mode right now. Thank you. I don't know why I just did that. There you go, that's what you're supposed to do. I was hoping for a Hail Mary, but I ended up fumbling. All right. Grab the drywall knife and the heat gun. Look how much oil is in this wood. It's just bubbling right out of there. So after this fiasco, I decided to change gears and go with something else. Just try to get my mind off it so I could figure out what was going on. So right here I'm building the string cover, I guess I would call it. And that's some goofy idea I had. I wanted to use a Les Paul style bridge, but I don't really like the tail pieces for them, so I'm going to use the bridge and then run the strings through the body, and then I'm making this thing right here to cover it up so you don't see them going into the body. Yeah, that angle was a bust. I'm trying to get the middle seam so I can book match it. I can live with that. This is how I see how the book matching should look before I cut it. I kind of decide on what areas I want to use and what I don't. I have no idea what happened there. get a little preview of what it should look like. Could use a marking gauge here, but I find it easy enough just to use your finger. Here I'm trying to decide where I want the string ferrules to go, so I know where to put the cover so I can cover them up. Spoiler alert, I'm using gold hardware. Looks like there's a lot of holes there already. Those are the wormholes in the walnut. I could almost used them. This will give me a rough idea of where I'm going to be. That's going to get carved, and there's a rebate cut in the bottom of it. It's going to be sunk into the body. There's the cavity routed out. Still needed to be cleaned up. Figured as long as I had the fretboard off, I'd clean up the hole.
Fretboard, take two. Kids, don't try this at home. It's a pain in the ass. And I'm running out of time. Leave a comment if you guys think I'll even finish this thing. Because to tell you the truth, I don't even know. I'm at the stage now where anything could happen. Anything could happen!
No, man, don't sing. Don't sing.
Okay.
All right, since you guys already saw me put one fretboard on, I kind of fast-forwarded through most of this. Show you some planing so you can see what this is going to look like. It's not a bad piece. It's not as good as the other one, that's all. Yeah, that's one thing. When you're planing in radiuses, you want to check to make sure it's flat a lot more often than you are with a sandy block. It's so easy to go off. Reestablish that center line. Now this fretboard was a quarter inch shorter than the one that I had previously had on there, so I did have to change the scale length a little bit. I think I went from 24 and 3 quarters to 24 and 9 sixteenths. So yeah, I got my old man glasses on. I find it easier to mark it all down the center once and then use a protractor to run line straight across, as opposed to marking each side and then connecting the lines. And I use Ben's three-step process again from the Clarity build. First, I use a razor to establish the initial line, and then I'll go back with a small saw to get a groove going, and then I'll go back with my fretting saw to finalize the groove. A smaller saw I was talking about. It's a pull saw. It looks really wobbly in this video, but it makes a damn straight line. Always make sure when you're using a saw to use the shiny surface. You want to make sure that wood looks like it's passing right through it. If it's going off at any angle whatsoever, then your saw's not straight. They're just finalizing them all. It may seem like a lot of work, but it's really not. Doesn't take that long. I figure I'll let the neck rest for a while. Body needs some cleaning up. I don't know if you could tell, but right below the middle hole, there's a little discoloration. That's where I actually broke through when I was doing the initial carve. That's just a little bit of super glue you can see. If you look in that recess, you can see four holes. My drill press will only reach those four. I can't reach the other two with the press. I have to freehand those. But with the cover on it, I can drill it from the backside, and if it busts out, it won't make much difference. There'll be a cover on it anyway. why I picked such a complex design for my first carve, I have no idea. Like I said before, if there's an easy way to do it, I'm going to do the complete opposite. Here, I'm just trying to clean up the bottom of all the lower spots.
Alright guys, I'm feeling a little bit better now. Still not 100% sure I'll finish up, but at least I got the new fretboard in place. I got some more of the carving done. I don't know, maybe I can put this on the wall or something later. This should be out Monday tomorrow, which gives me a little less than 10 days, or probably about 10 days to finish up. That includes some sort of finish, all the hardware, everything, strings, intonation, complete setup. So I'm going to be busy for the next couple days. Also, I noticed that my brother brought me my tuners. But I didn't realize that shalers, you can't reverse them. So I got a three aside, thinking I could reverse one because I got four and two, but I can't. So I had to order another one. And it's going to be here on the 15th. Yeah, a day or so before. So barring any major crisis, hopefully I'll have all my tuners. Because that would be a reason to have not a complete guitar. That would suck, wouldn't it? All right, thanks for watching. Subscribe, share, like, do everything you gotta do. I appreciate all of you guys, all your support. Following the comments have been incredible. Keep it up, man. I really enjoy getting back and forth with you guys in the comments. I really like seeing all your guys' builds. This is going to be a tough competition. I don't know how they're going to do it. I really don't. All right, man. Like I said, like, subscribe, all that stuff. Peace out.